Hello everyone, in this video we will study about the introduction of data structures and algorithms. So before moving ahead, I just want to bring you in your notice that we are living in a fast moving world where the terms like 5G, IoT, artificial intelligence, etc. are pretty common these days. In this video, you can see on the left hand side there is a driverless car, and on the right hand side this is the first humanoid, Sophia. So I just want to tell you that in this world we need very fast computations, we need algorithms that can work upon huge amount of data in a much accurate and faster way. So in that sense, the data structure subject becomes very essential for all the computer science graduates. So let's study about what is the basics of data structure. So data, as it says, it's the data, it's a kilobyte, megabyte data that we are generating every day, or the applications which we are using, social media, YouTube platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever data applications which we are using, every application is producing terabytes or petabytes of data every day. So it's a society which we are living today. It's a data driven society. We are living in lots of data all around. So definitely when there is a lot of data, we need a mechanism to organize the data which we have, and definitely this organization of data should be in a very appropriate way. It should be in a very structured way, so that we can work upon the data in a much accurate way. So definitely there are lots of real world problems that we are trying to resolve. For example, the driverless car is the one such example of the existing real world problems, although many companies like Tesla are already working upon that, but still the accuracy and the real time feedback of this car is still a challenge. So there are lots of problems open to be addressed, and we have lots of data which we need to work upon. So this data structure basically is the organization of data in a very structured way that the applications, those who are working upon that data, can effectively utilize the data in a very timely manner. And all of these operations should be very fast, and it should be very accurate. So basically data structure is like putting data into shelves or putting data into some libraries, so that you can choose or you can search the data, you can fetch the data as and when your applications or your programs require the data. So that's a basic idea of the term data structure is. One more common term is the algorithm that always comes with data structure. So basically an algorithm is, you can say, it's the plan to solve any particular problem. So it's basically a step-by-step plan that covers all the essential instructions that are required to solve a real world problem. And this algorithm is basically it's a kind of a black and white document, and we use pseudocode technique to write the algorithms. And one more term which we should discuss here is the program. So a program is the, you can say, computerized implementation of the algorithm. And definitely we need some programming language, and it could be any programming language of your choice. If you love C, you love C++, Python, Java, any programming language that you like, you can use that programming language to convert your algorithms into programs. So it's very essential for the beginners to know the difference between algorithm and program. So algorithm is basically the plan, the master plan to solve the real world problems, and the program is basically a computerized representation of the algorithm. Okay, so I hope the things and the terms are much clear now. So let's move on to the next slide. So this is one gives the example of an algorithmic solution. Here is the input instances to the algorithms, and there are some output instances. So definitely if there is an algorithm that needs some finite input, and it's going to produce some finite output, that is the solution of your problem. For example, if it is one of the algorithm of the driverless car, the input in this case could be the objects coming in front of the car, or the different road signs which are coming while the car is moving onto the road. Those kind of images will be the input instances, and the algorithm should be designed in a way that will process the data on a very timely way, in a very accurate way, and it should produce the output regarding the car should stop or car should take a turn, like that. So, and one more thing, you must be wondering how could there be a single master plan for any problem. So definitely this is not true. There could be many algorithmic solutions possible for any problem. And in fact, many scientists and many researchers so far suggested many algorithms to solve most of the problems, but this is sky's the limit. Still, there are people, researchers, they are again working upon those algorithms and making them much more better. So that's why there could not be a single solution of any problem. There could be different perception, different thinking, and different angles of perception which we need to find a solutions of the problem. And there could be different algorithms to solve any problem. For example, sorting. I suppose sorting is a very, very interesting example. So the sorting says, given some input numbers which are randomly, you can say random numbers which are having no association in between, they are not in order, and there should be one algorithm, there should be a plan which can sort the numbers. It means, so there should be a proper order in those numbers, whether it's ascending or descending, and definitely the output will be a permutation of the given input number. It means all if you have given n number of input, the output should contain all the n numbers, and it should be sorted. The output should be sorted. So this is one example, and now you can see there could be different ideas of sorting. In fact, there are many available sorting techniques. I hope you have gone through some of the sorting techniques like bubble sort, selection sort, radix sort, binary sorting. So many sorting techniques are there. It's basically binary search tree, and so many things are there which we can use to sort the given numbers. And definitely one important criteria in this case of sorting algorithm is the accuracy, or you can say correctness. The output should be correct. It should follow all the rules which you have decided for sorting. So it should be, all the numbers should be in ascending, or they should be in descending order. And so as we have discussed, there could be many algorithmic solutions possible to a given problem. So you must be wondering, if there are many algorithmic solutions possible, how are we going to select the best one? Because definitely everyone is interested for the best solution. What is the definition of best solution? So by best solution, we means the running time of any algorithm. So one more thing here, I just want to bring in your attention that algorithms cannot run on computers. So this running time, it means whether it's an algorithm written in a black and white or it's in a document way, still you can find out the running time of the algorithm. Okay, so we can assume there are some mathematical techniques which we can use to figure out the running time of the algorithms with the help of paper and pen. So it becomes quite easy for us to compare different algorithmic solutions of a given problem. So for example, mostly there are two major criteria which I have given on the left hand side, is the running time of any algorithm, which is definitely it's a very, very crucial factor, because everybody is interested in the efficient algorithms which can give you result in some fraction of seconds, in some microseconds, or it's like when you Google something, if you get results very quickly, you are getting very happy. Let's suppose if you are Googling something and Google will say you just wait for some hours, then I'll give you results, then you are not going to appreciate those things. So definitely the Google is using very good algorithm. Even they have their own algorithms developed by their team. So definitely those algorithms are appreciated worldwide, and these are the best algorithms. You can also work upon those algorithms, you can study algorithms, you can find out weakness among the existing algorithms, and you can suggest some more amendments to algorithms. So there's a vast scope available in this case. So for example, as I said, the efficiency of any algorithm can be measured by two major criteria. One is the running time, another one is space used. Let me tell you, space used is something like, as I tell you, space is something which we have plenty of space available these days. We are living in an era which we, where we have a lot of space available. So space is not at all a big deal these days. So now we are focusing on running time. So as the box it says, the running time of any algorithm depends upon the number of input. Definitely the number of input, that is n, that the n is a notion, denotes the number of input. Definitely if you are trying to sort, let's say 1,000 numbers, definitely it will be quickly sorted out. And suppose you are working on billions of number, then definitely it will take much more time to get the output. And one more parameter here, it says how partially sorted they are. It means, for example, in this particular case of sorting, if the input number are partially sorted, then definitely it's going to impact upon the output of the algorithm. So this is the property of the input, we can say. So it also depends upon the property or the nature of the input data which we are producing. So it also depends upon that. And definitely the algorithm which we are using, there are many algorithms, as I discussed about sorting, as I told you, bubble sort, selection sort, there are many algorithms available, and they are having different running time. So definitely, given a chance, you will definitely choose the algorithm which can sort number in a less time. So that will be your favorite algorithm. So we'll discuss more about this in the coming videos also. So the notion to denote this efficiency, mostly the we call it a running time, is the in the form of a mathematical function f, which is the function of n, which is number of or you can say size of input. So size of input, in terms of size of input, we can try to justify the running time of the algorithm. So quickly summarizing, so data structures and algorithm is two part, data structure and algorithm. So data structure basically covers the organization of data in a scientific way, in with the help of some proven principles. An algorithm is something, the master plan, you can say, to solve any real world problem. It gives you step by step solution in a finite way. There are some finite steps which works upon some finite input, and they produce some finite output. So that's algorithm. And in order to make a computerized solution of the algorithm, you need to convert that algorithm into programming form, and the program can be written with the help of any programming language you wish, C++, any language you can choose. So one more thing, there could be many algorithmic solutions possible to solve any particular problem, but we need to choose the best solution. The best can be something which gives a lowest running time. So this is the end of this session. Thank you.